TV censorship, especially on the networks, can be extremely strict. Late to catch up to movies, there have been plenty of controversial episodes studios have pulled over the years. Whether that's in totality, in specific territories, or only for a little bit, I'm Josh from WhatCulture.com, and these are 8 secret episodes TV shows don't want you to find. Number 8, The Twilight Zone, The Encounter. The Twilight Zone, while often terrifying, was also a platform in which the creators put forward their 2 cents on controversial topics. Sometimes it worked, and sometimes it didn't. And when it comes to The Encounter, it definitely didn't work out the way they planned. The episode in question saw 2 men, a Japanese-American man named Arthur Takamori, and a white World War II veteran called Fenton, trapped in an attic with a seemingly haunted samurai sword. The sword seemed to have mystical powers that influenced the 2 men to engage in heated arguments and a fight to the death. After the episode aired, though, complaints piled in from Japanese Americans due to the overtly negative Asian American characterization and language used, and as a result, the episode was removed from syndication and wasn't aired again for decades until 2016. However, the episode can be found on the DVD box set. Number 7, The Sweet Life of Zack and Cody, Smarter and Smarterer. The Disney Channel has tried many a time to tackle serious subjects on its beloved shows. Some of these episodes were huge successes, like the episodes of That's So Raven that addressed topics such as body image, racism, obesity, and smoking, but some of these episodes ended up doing more harm than good, like the Hannah Montana one that spread misinformation about type 1 diabetes. One of these aforementioned disastrous episodes also belongs to the hilarious hotel sitcom The Sweet Life of Zack and Cody. The episode, entitled Smarter and Smarterer, attempted to address the stigma that surrounds dyslexia. The plotline saw Zack, the non-academic twin, pretend to have dyslexia after making a new friend in class that seemed to get preferential treatment because of his learning disorder. But the mishandling of the subject matter made the episode seem condescending, and parents felt it seemed to make fun of children with dyslexia because of the comedic tone. The misstep raked in complaint after its airing, and subsequently only aired a handful more times globally. Clips of the episode can be found online, but as of right now, Disney have decided not to include it with the rest of the show's episodes on Disney+. Number 6, Family Guy, Partial Terms of Endearment. Of course, Family Guy makes this list. There's not a person on Earth that hasn't found something Family Guy did offensive. Whether it be an intentionally controversial topic or just lazy writing and bad jokes, hey, there's something for everyone. One of the more controversial episodes came in the form of Partial Terms of Endearment, though. The episode's plot saw Lois become a surrogate mother for one of her friends. However, when the woman dies, Lois is left to make a hard decision on whether to abort the child or keep it. It was the inclusion of terrible husband Peter trying to first cause Lois a miscarriage and then, when egged on by anti-abortion rallies, force her to keep the baby that made executives nervous. Consequently, the episode was never aired on American TV, but finally saw a release in the UK after consideration from execs. The episode is now included on the DVD box set. Number 5, Peppa Pig, Mr. Skinny Legs. Fears and phobias are something that parents for years have tried to address with their kids, and usually they don't do it all that well. So the responsibility, of course, falls to the secondary parents, that being television. And one of the biggest influences on the children of today is the myth, the legend, Peppa Pig. Of course, many British children have one fear in common. Spiders, obviously, and so obviously, Peppa had to step up and get involved. In the episode of Mr. Skinny Legs, Peppa and the family encounter an 8-legged friend. The episode attempted to teach children that there was nothing about spiders that they should be afraid of, and that befriending such insects is completely harmless. But there is a problem with that statement. You see, although Peppa is English, her fame reaches far beyond the UK. So when Australia got wind of Mr. Skinny Legs, they thought it prudent to ban the light-hearted episode, because as we all know, the spiders in Australia definitely aren't entirely harmless and could put children at risk due to misinformation. If you're British, then it's quite easy to find, but if you're Australian, well, good luck. Number 4, Friends, the one where Rachel tells. So, right now you might be thinking, hey, I've seen the one where Rachel tells, it's one of the most important episodes of that season, if not the show. And you're definitely right in that claim, but what you haven't seen and what you will never see is the original version of this episode. That's because the episode premiered on the 11th of October 2001, and if you're wondering what that date has to do with anything, then let me explain. Just a month prior, in September of course, America had suffered through the devastating attacks on the World Trade Center in New York. and understandably, in its wake, most TV shows and movies avoided storylines or imagery that reflected that real-world tragedy. The Friends episode I'm talking about today premiered exactly 1 month after these attacks, and one of its original plot lines was not at all appropriate. If you remember the episode, you might recollect the lighthearted B story of Monica and Chandler setting off for their honeymoon, only to be beaten to all the upgrades by another couple of newlyweds. Fun and completely non-controversial, right? Well, the original story that was cut from the show saw the couple get apprehended by airport security because of some tasteless jokes Chandler makes about bringing a bomb on the plane. Despite being written before the events, the storyline had clear parallels with the attacks that had just happened, and the showrunners were rightly worried about the response. So, they decided to rewrite the B story with a more lighthearted tone, and the scenes were all reshot. Number 3, The X-Files Home. Okay, we had to throw a classic on here. Sometimes, the more you want people to forget something, the more they want it, and that's definitely the case with this infamous X-Files episode. Home aired as the second ep of the fourth season, and although it did critically well, there was a lot of backlash. That's because the plotline revolved around a family of inbreeding, and Mulder and Scully are called to the town to investigate them after some neighborhood kids find the body of a newborn baby in the land outside their house. Though it might seem a little bit tame to what we're used to on TV now, and despite Home being one of the only X-Files episodes to start with a viewer discretion warning, people were in uproar at the time about such a storyline being shown on prime time. Consequently, the episode was taken off the air, seemingly for good. Of course, this only made people want to see it more, and the year after, FX ran an all-day marathon of the sci-fi series, where fans voted on which episodes they wanted to see. Home ended up, of course, being the most popular request, and FX were caught between a rock and a hard place, and ultimately chose to air it. And now you can finally watch Home on Disney+. Number 2, Beavis and Butthead, Comedians. Beavis and Butthead was created as a fun adult cartoon that follows two destructive teenage boys who enjoy watching TV and causing chaos. It targets an adult audience because, well, let's just say the titular boys themselves are not exactly role models. Of course, there are going to be kids out there that get exposed to things that are not necessarily for them, and Beavis and Butthead learned this the hard way. The first episode of the third season saw the two boys attempting a career in stand-up comedy. But when the audience takes poorly to the boys' act, Beavis decides to juggle on-fire newspapers, which subsequently burns the comedy club down. In the real world, this was watched by a 5-year-old who actually imitated the scene. The kid snuck out of bed one night to recreate the scene for real and burned his family's trailer and killed his baby sister in the process. When the studio got wind of this, of course, the episode was highly edited and pushed to a late night slot for its next viewing. However, this provided little help, and the episode was eventually pulled from syndication indefinitely, and even now you can't get it in its original form. Number 1, Hawaii Five-0, Bored She Hung Herself. Another case of someone watching something on TV and copying it to tragic results, but this time with an adult, not a child. This episode of Hawaii Five-0 featured a mystery where a young woman is found hanged, seeming to have killed herself. The suspects include her psychiatrist father and her boyfriend, a man that, among many things, is an obsessive meditator. A fan of the show saw his strange meditation technique and decided that she wanted to have a go for herself. Now, I'm really hoping I don't need to tell you guys this, but just in case, I absolutely will. Never ever take medical, fitness, health, or life advice from a fictional TV show. Because tragically, a poor woman also ended up imitating what she saw in this episode and ultimately killed herself. To avoid legal repercussions, the episode was promptly made to disappear by the show creators and the network, and it was never played on TV again, nor was it ever featured on a DVD box set. The only available evidence of the episode online at all are pictures from it and a plot description on fan websites. So yeah, this is one you probably will never ever see. So that's our list. I want some of you guys think down in the comments below. Are there any episodes of TV shows that the studios don't want you to see? And have you caught any of these? While you're down there as well, could you please give us a like, share, subscribe, and head over to whatculture.com for more lists and news like this every single day. Even if you don't though, I've been Josh. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you soon.